only 3% of that water on earth is fresh water. Of what 3%, only one is available as drinking water. The other 2% is frozen in polar ice caps. Americans use approximately 183 gallons of water each day for cooking, washing, flushing, and other purposes. The human body consists of almost two-thirds water, and water makes up 70% of the brain. Humans need 2.5 quarts of water a day for good health, at least, a minimum, okay? City water costs approximately $1.81 per 1,000 gallons compared to $1 per gallon for store-bought water. So, chemical sources. Chemicals will enter into tap water from many different types of sources, from pollution added to the water by public water systems, and most common of these chemicals is chlorine and fluoride. Next slide. Okay, so what are the health risks from chemicals? Even though chemicals are added to tap water to purify it and make it safe for drinking and cooking in homes, there's still health risks involved. Adding chlorine to water is actually adding a poison to the water we drink and use for bathing. Over time, chlorine taken in small doses will increase the risk of cancer, heart disease, gastric disturbances, and other health conditions. Most public drinking water systems use chlorine to purify the water. Next slide. Okay, so other chemicals that are found in drinking water are equally as deadly. Chemicals such as pesticides, fertilizers, and drinking water have been linked to birth defects. Yet chemicals have been used for years to purify our drinking water by killing the parasites that live within them. However, experts say that these parasites are becoming immune to the chemicals, just as they are to antibiotics, right? That we talked about last week, are living after purification treatments. These types of parasites will cause serious health problems in your digestive system. Next slide. Okay, so these are some of the parasites, and if you came to the medical missionary class, we talked about parasites. So these are some of them. I don't want to go through reading it. You can see it there on the slide. Okay, but these are some of the common ones. And giardia is found on surfaces of soil, food, or water that has been contaminated with fecal matter. Next slide. Dwarf tapeworm infection, drinking water contaminated with the eggs of parasites. It causes abdominal pain, severe weight loss, itching around the anus, and nervous manifestations. And certain types of E. coli are found in contaminated water. So you can just see the list goes on. Next slide. Okay, the government regulates the processing of drinking water through the EPA and the FDA. They're aware that dangerous chemicals may still remain in the drinking water while there are standards in place for the maximum amount that they say is safe, you know, but that level is zero. Meaning that there are dangerous toxins in the water which we are drinking from the tap. Large increases in cancer and other diseases have been reported in places where there have been poor processing of water purification systems. Next slide. And so you might say, I don't drink that water, but do you bathe in it? Yes. Do you wash your mouth out in it? Do you wash your hair? So do you still use that water for other things? Yes. Okay, so let's see, some of the chemicals that are found in your drinking water. Arsenic, this is an odorless and tasteless metal element which enters the drinking water supply from natural deposits as well as agriculture and industrial waste. Human exposure to arsenic can cause both short and long-term health effects, including cancer. Okay, bacteria, nasty pathogens from human waste and soil runoff frequently contaminate well and city water, posing a risk for serious illness under exposure. City water is commonly derived from treated sewage. How many of you know that? Treated sewage. Okay, chlorine. This is a free radical disinfectant that can quickly damage our hair, skin, and lungs when we bathe or shower. It has been shown to cause gastric upset upon ingestion and has been linked to malfunction of the liver and immune system with long-term exposure. Next slide. Chloramines. Now being added to nearly all municipal water districts, They are formed by a combination of chlorine and ammonia. Chloramines are so strong that they tend to dissolve the inside of your pipes and fixtures, releasing contaminants and heavy metal into the water. Chloramines have been linked to anemia, liver, kidney, and central nervous system problems, as well as reproductive effects. So if that does that to your pipes, you wonder what it could be doing to our bodies. Okay? Fluoride. Many communities receive pre-treated fluoridated water in their homes. Fluoride is known as the devil's poison. It has been shown to be less than effective in preventing tooth decay, while possibly contributing to a whole host of health problems. The dose that can cause immediate toxic consequences is more toxic than lead, but slightly less toxic than arsenic. This is why fluoride has been used in rodenticides and pesticides, so to kill your rats and your common pests in your home. Gasoline is easily absorbed in the soil. Even a small gas spill or leakage can contaminate groundwater sources, considered a hazardous waste material. Consumption has significant adverse effects on the central nervous system. So as the cars go down the road and there's gas leaks and things, you see trees, and people stop and pick, you know, fruit and things off of the trees that they see on the road. They could be contaminated with gas that's leaked into that soil. Hard water is the result of calcium and magnesium present in the water. These minerals form wide-scale buildup, creating problems for water heaters, washing machines, dishwashers. You all know about the calcium buildup. Hydrogen sulfide and sulfates. Hydrogen sulfide and sulfates occur naturally in rock soil. It can result from organic material or occur when wells are drilled. Although not a significant health risk, these elements can be a nuisance. Hydrogen sulfide gives off a rotten egg smell. Has anybody ever smelled that in your water?
Yeah.
Okay, and can produce stains on your fixtures and appliances. What happened there? Okay, on your pipes and damage to your plumbing. Iron. So iron in your water will present red staining on tubs, sinks. You see that in toilets a lot, right? Showers. What happened there? Okay, fixtures and your laundry. Okay, next one. Okay, so iron bacteria can be introduced to well water during drilling, repair, or service. If there's a rusty, moldy, or swampy odor associated with well water, an iron bacteria analysis should be conducted. And any of us who live in areas where we have wells and things like that, we need to have our water tested before we drink it. So magnesium, if you experience problems with brown or black staining of your laundry, this may be due to high concentrations of magnesium. Nitrates, these hazardous chemicals come from fertilizer, runoff, leaking septic tanks, sewage, and erosion of natural deposits. Nitrates are converted to nitrites in the body. High levels of nitrites have been shown to be deadly to infants under the age of 6 months and to cause serious health risks in others. So pesticides and herbicides, groundwater is often polluted by poorly managed fertilizers, insecticides, herbicides, and pesticides. And these poisons can easily sweep into well water, aquifers, and municipal water reservoirs. Exposure has been linked to chronic illness, birth defects, and immune system failure. Radon is a high risk of radioactive gas found in drinking water and indoor air. Exposure to radon in drinking water increases cancer risk, particularly lung cancer. Next slide. The city of Fort Lauderdale, this is in August of 2015, issued a boil water advisory. Now, I know you've all seen that. Someone told me about it, and I went and looked it up, okay? But they often, occasionally, on times, they do this, and we don't even know about it, okay? So one of my daughters called me and told me, did you know about that? And I, no. So I looked it up. Untreated water sample at one of the South Florida's water sources, wells tested positive for E. coli bacteria. And it included Oak Park, Lauderdale by the Sea, Port Everglades. You all know these areas. Authority, I don't. Village of Sea Ranch, Lakes, Wilton Manor, and sections of Davie and, what is that, Tamarack, east of Road 7. I know that I'm near Highway 7, right? or 441, right? Okay. So they said that you needed to boil your water. Residents of several Broward counties might notice a slight change in the smell. This is what they put out and taste of their tap water because the city of Fort Lauderdale would temporarily were going to add this chlorine to the water supply as part of its regular preventive maintenance ending November the 26th. Chlorination is a common practice to disinfect water systems. It was further stated that the Fort Lauderdale's drinking water meets federal, state, and local drinking water quality standards. So if they say you need to boil your water, what do you think boiling water is going to do? Is that going to kill the E. coli? Mm-mm. Okay, next slide. So what about Flint? Anybody remember the Flint water crisis? Okay, there was a lot in the news about Flint and how they had been on the Detroit water system from the river there, and they cut them off. Flint, which is about 60 miles northwest of Detroit, returned to using the city water in October after tests found elevated levels of lead in the water and in the blood of some of the children. The more corrosive water from the Flint River leached lead from the city pipes more than Detroit did, leading to problems. Next slide. So this is some of the water that the people were showing, and they began to protest. It was a public health crisis, and they were telling them that the water was safe to drink. Next slide. These are the people they took to the streets. These are the samples of water that they had in Flint, because they had put them on the water of the Flint River. Okay. So, secondly, state officials insisted for months that the water was safe. And despite growing evidence that they had reliable information showing how toxic the water was, it truly was, everyone from homeowners to hospitals was affected by the contamination, which the water turned a dirty shade of brown. Next slide. So this is the water, and this was in a hospital, which was supposed to be a sterile area. Okay, so Flint's children have experienced elevated lead levels, and the number is rising. Would you give your child that water? Look at that. Okay. Despite civic concerns, officials assured residents that there was nothing to worry about. But to alleviate the people's anxieties, the city said they would provide free bottled water, putting a band-aid on the problem. Next slide. Okay, so what can we do to protect ourselves? So many of you say, okay, well, you know, we can turn to bottled water. So what does the scripture say, Lamentations 5:4? We have drunken our water for money, our wood is sold unto us. Many people have been turning to bottled water in order to avoid drinking tap water. However, the main problem with any type of bottled water is the containers which it comes in. The plastics which are used to make the containers contain chemicals as well. These chemicals are absorbed by the water when it comes in contact with the container and have been proven to cause cancer. So if you get bottled water, you need to keep it out of the sun, and you don't need to keep it for a long period of time because it starts leaching the chemicals from there. The best way to guarantee that you are drinking water, which is pure, would be to install a carbon filter for a water purification system. These are proven to be cost-effective, and it will remove almost 100% of the toxins that leaves your drinking water with only healthy minerals. Install carbon shower heads. You can go to Home Depot and get a shower head for like $19.95 and twist off your shower head, put it on, and then put your shower head back on, and it filters. I've done that in the apartment that I'm staying in just so that I don't shower with the water that comes from the city. Okay, if you're on well water, as I mentioned before, you should have it tested. Next slide. So find out what's in your water. As a part of the Safe Drinking Water Act, the Environmental Protection Agency, the EPA, requires the city of Fort Lauderdale and all community water systems to provide its customers with a consumer evidence report. Okay, the CCR, commonly referred to as the Water Quality Report. It comes out every year, July 1st. So if you're concerned or you want to know what's in your water in the area you live in, you can go on the internet and find out. These are some of the water filters. This one's $56, and you can just put it right under your sink. Go to the next slide. okay, under the counter water filters. So you can place this one under, this is a do-it-yourself thing. You know, if I can read directions to do it, anybody can just about do it. Next slide. And this is the shower head I'm telling you about. That is really simple. You just unscrew. So how many of us are showering in the regular water? All of us, right?
No.
Not me anymore.
Not me.
Okay. So, all right. So that's the end. And let's see, Lamentations 22:33. It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. May the grace of the Lord be with us all. Let us pray.